Governor, you said yourself that you struggled with the issue of same-sex marriage for several years, being a practicing Catholic. So before deciding, of course, to go ahead with introducing this legislation, what made you change your mind?
You know, I really had to sort out my faith and my responsibility as both a three-term attorney general and now as governor. And I came to the understanding that I could honor and respect the freedom of religion of all faiths in Washington State to decide who they want to marry, but that I could not allow the state to continue to discriminate when they issue a license for someone to get married. So my seven-year journey has been one that it's been hard for me. My state's been on a journey. In 2009, our voters stepped up and passed domestic partnerships. But that alone doesn't make people equal, so it's time for equality in marriage in Washington State.
Your push on this has really lit up the internet. What has been the reaction, as far as you can tell?
You know, the emails that I have received, the messages, the telephone calls at the front desk have been not just from my own state, but around the country and around the world. And what I hear is equality is absolutely necessary. Finally, someone is recognizing how important it is. Separate but equal doesn't work here any more than it worked in the 60s in racial discrimination. And so it has been a showing of what has been to me very surprising but wonderful support, and particularly by loving couples and children saying it's time that we be recognized as equal to any other couple in any other family.
There are some conservative Democrats who don't support same-sex marriage. Do you think that you have the support you need?
Well, I'm pretty assured that we do have enough votes in our House of Representatives. It's going to be a struggle in my Senate, to be honest with you. But I will tell you, I think the voters of the state of Washington, and there's polling now, as I understand it, that says the voters are there. So it's time for my legislature to catch up with my voters. But I also think it's time for all of my generation to listen to our children, to listen to grandchildren, who will tell you what is it that you get about inequality that makes it right when it comes to gay couples, but somehow you got and understood it and fought for it when it came to racial discrimination in the 60s. And as I hear their voices, they're absolutely right. We have to have equality in marriage for these families, these loving families and their children in my home state. It's right. It's the right time. I hope my legislature will get it done in the regular session.
Why did you wait until your last year in office to make this move?
You know, we have been through a journey in 2006. For the first time, we were able, under me, to get a bill that said no more discrimination in housing and employment. And the next year, we took the step to domestic partnership and expanded it the year after. Then, as I mentioned, in 2009, the voters embraced it. So I think the state has been on its own journey, and now we see people, we understand it's our moms, our dads, it's our children, it's our aunts, our uncles, our friends, our neighbors. And so we say they're fighting for the same things we are. They're fighting for democracy in our military. They're families that are fighting for their children. They're looking for a good job and how to make ends meet. Why do we not recognize the equality of their loving relationship like we do any other couple in my state? So I knew the issue was going to be confronting me this legislative session. I had to come to grips with it. It has been a seven-year personal battle for me, and I will tell you, I feel so much better today than I have over the last 7 years, because I'm fighting for the right thing, which is equality in my home state. That's the right thing for the people of my state. I frankly think it's the right thing for America.